everyone, welcome to Oil Life. We are here today with our awesome grand opening of the new book that we'll be unveiling. It's called The Essential Mixologist, and we have Jules Weinberg with us here, who is the author and creator of this book. So welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
It's exciting. So we're excited to kick this off and tell you a little bit more about it, as well as make some recipes. So it's going to be a great night. So first of all, Jules, can you tell us a little bit more about yourself? Who are you?
Sure. Yeah. Well, my name is Jules Weinberg, and I am a Blue Diamond with doTERRA. And I'm a plant lover, and I love essential oils. I've been working with essential oils for almost 20 years, and I have a background in mixology and playing with essential oils and infusing them into all kinds of things, foods, drinks.
Very cool.
Cocktails, mocktails, elixirs.
Yes, I love that. So, and then this book. So tell us, what was your inspiration for this book? Why did you come up with it?
Yeah, well, you know, as I said, and you can read the book too, because the story's in the book.
Definitely.
But I have a background using essential oils and infusing them into drinks for a pretty long time. And when I found doTERRA, the quality of these oils spoke to me in such a way and gave me the freedom, the creative freedom, because the quality is so high that I could really start to play with them. And I just felt like it was something that I wanted to share with people. I feel like there is a niche out there for people that are really interested in this in our industry, and I thought it'd be really nice to create a roadmap for them and give them a tool that they could use to grow the industry, grow their team.
Yes. Yeah. And so you are going to be able to share that tonight.
Yeah.
We do have our live audience here with us as well, so thank you all for being here as well. And everyone, say hi, everyone. So we're all going to get a chance to taste test these recipes, learn a little bit more. So, Jules, tell us, what are we making tonight?
Okay, so we're going to make three different drinks tonight. We're going to do a cocktail called the Purest Margarita. We're going to do a mocktail called the Jules Julep. And then we're going to do another mocktail called a Mango Lassé. And I'll go into some details as I'm making the drinks.
Great. And you'll tell us a little bit more where they came from.
Absolutely. Yeah,
perfect.
We'll play.
I'm excited. And we're going to get some awesome people up here to taste test them and get a little feel of that. So
that
I'll turn
great.
The time over to you.
Okay,
let's get started.
All right. So we're going to start with the Purest Margarita. And, you know, part of my inspiration, when you ask me about inspiration, is I really come from this purist perspective. And I just believe that food should be in its purest form. I love the taste of real fruits, flowers, vegetables, and I think that there's a lot of contrived ingredients out there in the world. And what I love about essential oils is it is the essential essence of that flavor. It captures it unlike any other ingredient on the planet. So we're gonna start with the Purest Margarita. We're gonna fill our shaker with ice. Now, anybody can do this at home, and that's kind of like my thing, is like, I'm not like the rock star mixologist. I just have some really cool recipes that I like to share with people, but I like to make it really approachable for everyone. So get yourself a couple of shakers and you can do anything. So we start with ice, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna do, cut up some limes here. Now this is our we're doing a cocktail here. So we're gonna use a Blanco tequila. Any spirit, I'm a huge proponent of finding artisan small batch companies that are distilleries and produce in small quantities, because I really believe that the bigger corporations, you know, use stuff that we don't wanna put in our bodies and their ingredients. So this is a really good brand. And we're gonna do an ounce of that. And I like fresh limes. To me, there is nothing like a fresh lime, right? Everybody loves the flavor of a fresh lime. You can do store-bought lime juice, but it's just not as good. It just doesn't have that fresh, delicious flavor. These are really handy. They make it a lot easier. These are smaller limes. I usually use about a lime and a half per cocktail. But these are smaller, so I'm gonna go ahead and do two full limes. Okay. All right. Okay. Now I like to use agave. And in the book I talk about a squirt. Now, you know, depending on what your sweetness level is, a squirt could be a hard squirt or a soft squirt. I kind of go medium there on the squirt. And then the very special ingredient in the purest margarita is our wild orange essential oil. Now, a margarita is usually fresh lime juice, usually a Blanco tequila, and some kind of like triple sec, or if it's fancier, it's Grand Marnier or Cointreau. All those is a concoction of very sugary, syrupy, you know, and it's an alcohol that is added for that orange flavor. But I say, why not use the wild orange? Because you're getting no calories, it's low insulin, low glycemic on the body, and it's filled with more flavor than any of those. So I go ahead and I put 2 drops of the wild orange. Now, we all know essential oils, they can come out pretty fast, so you gotta really watch it, okay? Now, I like to salt the glass with Himalayan sea salt because it's just a really wonderful salt. That was a little trick. You can use the lime and it gets the glass so the salt will stick. Okay. Isn't that beautiful? It just makes a really nice presentation. I love the contrast of the pink. And then I'm an ice cube girl. I really think ice cubes matter. And these are very pretty square ice cubes. They bought me these trays, which I have at home. You can buy these online because I think presentation matters. Okay. Just do 3 of those. Okay. You know what? These limes are very small. I can kind of feel it, so I'm going to add 1 more. Smell it out there. Now, I have made these for probably hundreds of people at this point. We do events all the time. And wild orange, as many of you know, is just so restorative. It's amazing for, it's uplifting, it's nourishing to the nervous system, it's a contribution to our immune system. I can't tell you how many people have come into our events and they're feeling a little tired, they're feeling a little sluggish, and I start mixing up the drinks, and always within about a half hour, I've got a little crew in the kitchen saying, I feel better from this margarita. Now, not 2 things that would usually go in the same sentence, but it's true, and I know it's not the tequila that's making them feel better, so we all know what is making them feel better. I like to give things a good shake, and then this inevitably happens. Okay. All right. Oh, that smells so good. And who would love to come up here and be my taste? All right. That is the purest margarita, what I think is probably the best margarita on the planet. Yeah. Please have a little sip. That recipe is in the book.
Yeah. And the color of it. So
isn't that
pretty.
Beautiful? Yeah.
Yes, and again, contrasting
you get
with
that,
the pink.
Yeah, that Himalayan sea salt really pops.
So pretty, yeah. So, what's next? What are we making next?
Okay, I'm my own bar back here, so I just need a little transition second here. Okay, should we just leave these on the side?
We can leave it. It's pretty. I say we keep it out here.
Okay, perfect. So now we're going to go into mocktails.
Okay.
Okay, so every recipe in the book, you can make it with or without alcohol, and I really want to, you know, get that point across. And there's 2 recipes in there that are just pure elixirs, so there's no alcohol to start. Okay. But they taste delicious either way. So this is called a Jules Julep. Is there any Kentucky people in the house?
No.
Well, this is the official drink of the Kentucky Derby. And again, normally made with a liqueur called creme de menthe, and you know, I think we can do better because again, that's just sort of like a syrupy concoction of, you know, fake spearmint. And I tasted one for the first time when I was in Kentucky visiting some family, and I thought we can do a lot better here. So we've got this beautiful spearmint oil.
Okay.
And we're gonna again, we'll fill the
Let's
cup with ice. Let's do it.
I'm excited.
Okay, so this is gonna require us to reach a little further we're gonna make our own cucumber juice. And you know, again, I like everything to be approachable for people. Some people are like, oh, you know, fresh cucumber juice, how in the world am I gonna do that? It's so easy. Take a blender, fill it up with about 3 cups of water, and just cut a bunch of cucumbers up. We had them pre-peeled so that I wouldn't be peeling them in front of you. Probably should have pre-cut them. Thank you, Meredith, for peeling them. And I'm gonna add, I'm gonna do 3 cucumbers. And we're gonna make some cucumber juice. For those of you that don't use a knife, don't cut as fast as I just did. You gotta like put your fingers like that, cut your fingers off. Okay, and we're just gonna not blend it. What do we got? Let's see. Maybe the power is not on. Perfect, we'll turn the power on first, which it is now. So beautiful. Okay, so how easy was that? Was that easy? Can we all agree that we can make homemade cucumber juice? I love mason jars. I'm a mason jar girl. And it's just a great way to store anything. So you could, oh, that's very pureed. Okay. It's not a Vitamix. That's okay. Actually, I'm kind of a perfectionist. I'm going to put it back in and blend it a little more. Okay. I'm used to my Vitamix. All right. Okay, there we go. That'll be a better consistency. So you can store anything in a mason jar. Keeps for, I would say some of this cucumber juice probably keeps for about a week. And you can have it and you can do all kinds of stuff with it. Okay, so let's do this. So we're gonna do some cucumber juice. This is my version of a julep. Remember, it's a Jules julep. So it's not quite the julep that we're used to. I use maple syrup to give it a little sweetness. Now, usually there's some bourbon in this and we're leaving out the bourbon. So just know that you can use the bourbon or not. We're omitting. Put some nice, I use maple syrup because I find that maple syrup goes very nicely with bourbon if you were going to use bourbon. It gives it a really nice flavor. Okay, and we're gonna use 1 drop of spearmint oil because a little goes a long way on this. Okay, and spearmint oil is just, it's so uplifting, it's good for your digestion. I mean, it's got so many wonderful benefits. The traditional mint julep uses crushed ice, so we're going traditional here. This was freshly crushed by these wonderful women here. Thank you so much. Isn't that beautiful? Mm-hmm. Okay, top, there we go. Shake this up. I need some help. There we go. Got those. Okay. Smells so good. You can kind of get the different aromas that are happening, right? Isn't that beautiful how it just pours over the ice like that? Okay, and this gets fizzy water. That's the other part of it. Okay, isn't that beautiful? Okay, pardon me for not having a proper stirrer, but I'm gonna use my knife. There we go. And now we garnish it with a nice mint sprig. And that is a Jules julep. I think we had someone volunteer to taste it. So pretty.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is awesome.
Refreshing, right?
Yeah. and take another drink. That's really good.
I love that. And it's so pretty the way that you garnish it. So add some flavor, and it just looks good. Okay, so we're getting ready for number three.
We What's are number going three? Into number three. So let me just get that stored. Okay.
I'm glad that you made the cucumber juice on film, because that's something that I never have really learned how to make, but it's easy.
It's so easy, and you can use it in so many different things. Like, you can put a little cucumber juice in some water and just a drop of spearmint oil and serve it, you know, to your guests. You can have like a little in-home spa.
Definitely.
Drink.
That sounds incredible.
Okay, number three. We're going to do a mango lassé.
Yeah.
Now, this is... I'm just cleaning out all my stuff as we go along.
Here, to this. So, now we're going to make this last one. It's, let me remember, the mango lassé?
Yes.
Okay.
It's a mango lassé. So, this is my take on a mango lassé. A mango lassé is a really delicious drink that you'll find in Indian cuisine. And it's traditionally made with yogurt and mango, and there's some other wonderful ingredients. And they use it, you know, it's high in probiotics. So I thought, oh, it'd be really cool to kind of riff on that and make a cocktail. We're going to do the mocktail version of it. So
what oils are we using in this?
We're going to use cardamom.
Okay.
We're going to use cardamom oil, which, again, really good for digestion, really supportive in that way. It's also supportive to your respiratory system.
Definitely.
I love cardamom. It's one of my favorite flavors, and it's really warming in the winter.
Yeah.
So, okay.
Well, it's winter time. It's perfect.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
Okay, all right, let's do
see
this.
It.
So, traditionally, the recipe uses white rum, because rum is from sugarcane, and it kind of pairs well with the mango. But we're going to do a mocktail version of it now. So we're going to do mango. Now, I always use, if we're not going to do fresh mango, which we didn't have time to make like fresh juices for everything, I always like to use something organic, and I talk about that in the book and why it's so important to choose organic ingredients. So we're going to use mango. Okay. Now, you can use almond milk, you can use coconut milk. You can go ahead and go for it and use yogurt if you want. You can use regular milk. There's really no rules. And I also, in the book, I say permission to modify, because these are my recipes that I love. They're the things that I like to taste. But you might have different palates. You might think that, you know, something's too sweet, or it needs more of this, or it needs more of that. So you have permission to make it how you like it. So I'm going to use coconut milk. I really like coconut milk. And by the way, the exact amounts are in the book. We just thought, for the sake of speed, we would just go for it. Okay, and a special ingredient in this is rose water. So, a little of this stuff goes a long way. Now, you can make your own rose water. But in our company, you have to have won a contest to have that rose oil. I like to serve this in a tall glass. I just think it's pretty. Let's see, what else am I missing? Oh, the cardamom oil. Okay. So one drop of cardamom. Okay. All right. The first time that I'm using these, they're not broken in yet. Jeez. This one just doesn't want to come off. I might need some muscles up here. I might need a dude. Hang on. I need a bar back, right? Okay, I got it off. Hilarious.
Okay.
All right. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes.
Yeah. Ooh, and she does a perfect pour. All right. And just for a garnish on this, I just like a little cracked cardamom, because it's just so pretty. And and I don't know who wants to come and taste that. Do we have any volunteers?
I'll taste it.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. Oh my gosh, that's so good. I'm gonna have another.
Well, I mean, I guess everyone that tasted it, it's kind of yours. You own it, mm-hmm. right? It's flu season.
It's mine. Nobody touch it. So good.
Go ahead and enjoy it.
Take it with you. That's awesome. Can I get a round of applause? That was amazing. And I just want to see a raise of hands. Who here is excited to taste these? Woo! Yeah, me too. So we are going to do a little taste testing after.
Let's do it.
But we're going to tie it up. Any last words you want to say to our online viewers?
You know, it's being in the hot seat, being up here.
Yeah.
I think we all did well. I appreciate everybody's support. This is the first time we've gone live in this way. We've done many little webinar events in our kitchen, but it's just Meredith and I. So, you know, I appreciate all of you and feeling your support. And play, you know, just have fun. I think I love what we do. It's been a real blessing to be a part of this company. And I'm so grateful I've got my team here. And they came from so far to be with us here together. And yeah, just play, have fun. You know, there's so much that's available to us in these little bottles. I mean, it's truly magic. And that's what I want to do is inspire people to just play with them in lots of different ways and let them dance with you.
That's awesome. Yeah. So a couple other recipes to make in here, right?
Oh, there's 22 original recipes in there.
That's amazing.
Yep, using, you know, a plethora of oils. So for those of you in the room who are wellness advocates, this is a wonderful tool and a wonderful way to turn people onto the oils. And there's a kit suggestion in the back. And I'm very mindful that whoever, you know, brought you to the book is who you need to go and get those oils from. I'm just here giving a message and turning people onto other ways that they can use them. So my intention is to help doTERRA grow in a different way, you know, using the oils in this way and to help all of you grow your teams as well.
Definitely.
Your businesses.
I love that. Yeah. Okay, well, thanks for joining us.
We appreciate it. Thank you so much for having me.
And thank you to our online viewers. We will see you next week. Thanks, guys. Yeah.